People who truly understand what is meant by self-reliance know they must live their lives by ethics rather than rules. Technology and the impact of technology seems to change at unprecedented rates. Our laws and rules also change, but nowhere near the rate of change for technology. It can feel like the story of the tortoise and the hare, a race between unequal partners, inviting conflicting interpretations. Technology, the hare, races to the finish line, while the laws, the tortoise, plod along to the finish line methodically, eventually catching up. Ethics can help us navigate this perplexing race between technological change, rules, and the law. What is ethics, anyway? Ethics is the study of what it means to do the right thing. At times, the right thing is not always obvious. The study of ethics goes deep, and separate points of view emerge on the topic. Some will regard ethics as universal, unique, and applying to all, while others consider ethics to be more like a set of rules, providing a framework in a given context. Most assume ethics involves rational people making free choices. We may hear the terms ethics and morals used interchangeably. We might ponder ethics as what ought to be the right thing, and morals as what is the right thing during a given moment in time. As we engage the topic of ethics and technology, we'll want to consider these differences. We'll also want to keep in mind the different ways that we look at ethics and the philosophical approaches to ethics. One such approach is a deontological approach. With this approach, ethics are more like absolute rules which must always be applied, regardless of the consequences. The classic example of this approach is the rule, "Do not lie under any circumstance." We can, however, think of many examples where holding to the rule may lead to bad consequences. Another ethical approach is that of utilitarianism. With utilitarianism, we consider the consequences of an act, determine how it relates to the affected people, and we calculate the utility of the act. With this approach, we consider an act good if it increases utility for all, and wrong if it decreases it. Like the deontological approach, however, we might see shortcomings with utilitarianism. While an act can increase utility for all, it can hurt individuals. This conflict of bad consequences with a deontological view and damage to individuals with utilitarianism leads us to consider the natural rights of the individual. A natural rights approach views ethical behavior as acting in such a way that respects a set of fundamental rights of others, including the rights to life, liberty, and property. A natural rights approach tends to focus on the results of how people interact. A natural rights approach would consider an act unethical if it leaves some people at a loss of these fundamental rights. Rights in the interpretation of them are often conceived as negative or positive rights. It might be easier to use the terms liberties and claim rights instead of negative and positive when we study ethical issues in computing. Negative rights or liberties are thought of as allowing people to act without interference. This approach views ethical behavior as acting in such a way that respects a set of fundamental rights of others, including the rights to life, liberty, and property. We can cite many things the U.S. Declaration of Independence and the First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution which guarantee us negative rights or liberties. Positive rights or claim rights, on the other hand, can be considered rights that impose something on people for the benefit of others. For example, a radio station may not want to provide airtime for everyone. When we force a radio station to provide equal airtime for political ads, we are doing so by interpreting freedom of speech as a claim right. As you might surmise, liberties and claim rights can come into conflict. As such, it may befit us to clarify how we interpret rights when we discuss them. The Golden Rule is a general rule for how to behave that says you should treat people the way you like other people to treat you. When it comes to ethical behavior, the Golden Rule may be a valuable resource. It is simple and direct, yet leaves room for choice and consideration of others. One thing that is clear is that solving ethical problems is not free from doubt nor easy. Human behavior, choices, and actions can be very complex. As we contemplate our ethical choices, let us consider these factors. At times, acts can be thought of as right, wrong, or okay. Harm alone may not be enough to call an act unethical. Goals and constraints may come into conflict when taking action. Ethical decisions may be considered right or wrong, yet we personally may approve or disapprove of them. And ethical principles may help us pass laws which can set standards and leave room for voluntary choice.